Spagels.
Our first film is The Crossroads, otherwise known as La Crossi das Gemis, released in 2009, written, directed, shot, and scored by one David Apulkaya. A platoon of Allied soldiers have been stranded deep in enemy territory due to orders from their incompetent commanding officer. Now trapped behind enemy lines, they must band together and fight their way to freedom. Through countless ambushes and tragedies, all amidst the horror of war, these soldiers must find their way to freedom and ultimately find themselves. Oh, Christ. If The Crossroads had not been 2 hours long and packed in more action sequences, I could see myself giving it a pass. But what we have here is not a war action film, but a war epic, woefully underfunded and ill-equipped to be so. Being shot on late 2000s digital video, I do feel bad when saying the color grade was washed out garbage, but still, it has to be said, it was washed out garbage and the most notably bad creative decision out of many on display in this film. We also have to deal with terrible shaky cam, overbearing music, an over-reliance on natural lighting, and over-the-top acting by its French cast. Not to mention the little things such as poor sound design, CGI explosions, and cheap-looking weapons and costumes. Again, if this was an honest-to-God war-sploitation affair, I would be more lenient. But unfortunately for me, and anyone else watching, Mr. Apulkaya had higher ambitions. The most French aspect of this film, apart from its all-French-speaking cast that is its script, which is not as bad as most reviewers online have suggested. There is some decent drama to be found here, and the dialogue, for the most part, is articulate, poetic, philosophically sound, and presents the most whimsical portrayal of US Marines outside of a comedy. The Crossroads fails most with its attempts to recreate that particular brand of Spielbergian sentimentalism as all World War II dramas post Saving Private Ryan attempt to do. And since we all know the French are all up in that kind of chintzy bollocks, it should be no surprise that The Crossroads hams it up to the point of absurdity, undoing all the goodwill it built with its audience through its message and genuine attempt at obtaining an epic scope. What we are left with is a low-budget historical melodrama with severe inaccuracies and awful pacing. Right, from World War II to World War Never Gonna Fucking End with Tour of Duty from 2015, previously known as Painkillers, directed by Peter Wimpfer. Led by Major John Cafferty, a mercenary group is sent deep into the mountainous regions of Afghanistan with orders to retrieve a mysterious and top-secret package. Upon their return, they awake in a private facility with no memory of what happened or who they are and half of their team dead. Fed a new PTSD drug to help induce their memories, a secret comes to light, just before they're sentenced to death. Playing out more like a sci-fi channel film than an action war film as its DVD packaging suggested, it's immediately evident that Tour of Duty's screenplay is better than average, maintaining an impressive juggling act of military-industrial complex conspiracies, paranoia thriller tropes, and well-rounded characters to sugar it all on top. The plot twists are skillfully executed and the lore built up around them is both accessible and believable. It's a TV movie for sure, with its basic lighting and camera work, which make no attempt to hide the fact that most of this was shot on a studio set, but what these kind of low-budget sci-fi TV shows lack in aesthetic quality, they make up for in plot density. Some dialogue was also inaudible, but I was never confused by any series of events. The story just keeps going, and I found myself never too bored for long. For a B-movie such as this, that is high praise indeed, and it is deserved. This is a conspiracy thriller done right. It has self-awareness, it cares for its characters, the cast is game, and the plot is engaging. I had fun. This is the kind of normie, middle-of-the-road fare I just can't get mad at. It doesn't promote any dangerous ideas, it's never too mean-spirited, and it's fast-paced throughout. Maybe I don't see myself watching this again, but as someone who is well-versed in direct-to-DVD genre films, trust me when I say that there are way worse ways you can spend 101 minutes. And finally, our third film is Massacre at My Life 4 from 2009, directed by Paolo Bertola. Taken from the Pulitzer Prize winning reports of Seymour Hersh, Massacre at Mile High 4 recounts the true and harrowing story of what happened that fateful day in 1968 when a platoon of US soldiers massacred the men, women and children of a rural Vietnamese village. Falling into an ambush, the men of 2nd Lieutenant William Calley's Charlie Company come under enemy fire, and in the disastrous fight that ensues, three young soldiers lose their lives. Gripped by tension and hysteria, the platoon moves on, eventually coming to a small fishing village where they give vent to their thirst for vengeance. In a journey filled with violence and terror, the soldiers go through a collective personality change and, in a state of frenzied delirium, execute Callie's ever more crazed orders. What the fuck was this? As I Live and Breathe, an Italian macaroni combat film made in the year of our Lord 2009. The trash hound inside me should be leaping outside and bouncing up the walls. Pity then that this red-brown spirited opera happens to be telling the story of the most infamous atrocity committed in the most infamous war of the last century. Situated somewhere between the last films of Bruno Mattei and Uwe Boll's Tunnel Rats, Massacre at Mile High 4 is at times a comically over-dramatized depiction of the events that led to the aforementioned village massacre. The acting, unless you're well-versed in the Italian Genoa cinema school of acting, is jaw-dropping in its cartoonish quality. These were real people, killing and dying, and in true Italian tradition, everyone and everything is reduced to good and evil and all the sadism in between. It is near impossible to take any of this seriously, and considering the source material, the film is borderline ghoulish because of that. Your limit may vary on the ironic entertainment value of this film's poor taste, but it definitely is there, and it lays itself open to ridicule. Also, in the Italian tradition, Massacre at Mile High 4 actually looks like it had an alleged $2 million budget, and then some. Some close-ups and tracking shots are legit on a studio level, and the overall cinematography is top-notch. Then they had to go and implement some 1997 CGI into the proceedings and drag it all back down to the bargain bin. So close, yet so far. How can I summarize this trash? It has to be seen to be believed. No matter how authentic the screenplay attempted to be, the execution is so tone-deaf it comes off as nothing more than exploitation. The bad feels kind at that. Some of the imagery is really dark, and the film did not earn it. This was crap. So, field report. The Crossroads is melodramatic French toss that is overlong and done on the cheap. Tour of Duty is a stellar B-movie with a good plot and good pacing. And Massacre at Mile High 4 pisses upon the victims of a horrific and emblematic chapter in the Vietnam War with tone-deaf acting and a screenplay that uses tasteless amounts of creative license. Salut.